Disclaimer, the scenario is completely fiction, and does contain valid tones, and should not be played on the air in any circumstances. If you play these tones on the air, you could be fined or arrested big time, and could cause mass panic across your area. This video also contains scary and loud noises, that may not be suitable for young children. If you don't like loud or scary noises, then click away from this video now. I hope you enjoy this video, and thanks for watching.
When I heard a voice behind me say, "Now, ain't she something, son?" I said, "Yeah, she's quite a woman." And he just stared at me. And I realized that in his eyes, she would always be playing Cinderella, riding her first bike.
Message is transmitted at the request of the United States Geological Survey. At 10:21 a.m. Mountain Standard Time, the United States Geological Survey has detected an earthquake with a magnitude of 8.7 on the Richter scale in Bruno, Idaho. Massive damage has been reported, as several buildings and homes have been destroyed, resulting in many casualties. Aftershocks have already been reported in portions of Nevada, and it is believed that aftershocks will occur in cities such as Hot Spring, Grand View, Collier Place, Hammett, Glens Ferry, and other surrounding communities. All residents receiving this message are advised to prepare for aftershocks, as they can be destructive and deadly. Tune into other TV or radio stations for more information on this developing situation.
On the bed and looking for a pillow fight. Popsicle grin, dancing with her dad, looking up at him. He gives me a hard time. I can't blame the fella, I'm the one who's stealing Cinderella.
They came for the 2-for-5.
You got a 2-for-5, right?
Yeah.
But they were surprised with a special side.
What? The best $5 I spent.
More surprised than I've been in my entire life.
volcano watch in effect for areas within a 500-mile radius of the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States Geological Survey and the Federal Emergency Management Agency. At 10:39 a.m. Mountain Daylight Time, the United States Geological Survey has detected some volcanic activity at the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano located in southwest Idaho. This is due to an earthquake with a magnitude of 8.7 that struck near the caldera at around 10:33 a.m. Mountain Standard Time today. Although a volcanic eruption is very unlikely, all residents are advised to take extra precautions in case if a volcanic eruption occurs. Continue to monitor local media stations for the latest information when it becomes publicly available.
At 9 p.m. in Boise, cloudy, temperature 37 degrees, dew point 28, relative humidity 59%, winds northwest at 6 miles an hour, pressure 30.31 inches and rising. In McCall, cloudy, temperature 39 degrees, dew point 27, relative humidity 57%. Transmitted at the request of the United States Geological Survey and the Federal Emergency Management Agency. This is not a test. To repeat, this is not a test. A volcano warning is now in effect for all areas within a 500-mile radius of the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano. It has been confirmed by the United States Geological Survey that the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano located in southwest Idaho is on the verge of reawakening and erupting. This is due to a large earthquake with a magnitude of 8.7 that was epicentered at the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano. A volcano warning means that a volcanic eruption is imminent and is expected to erupt within the next 12 hours. Residents receiving this message are advised to evacuate immediately. Gather the necessary supplies such as food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a fully charged cell phone, phone chargers, and a battery-powered or hand-crank radio for your journey. Do not pick up relatives from schools, hospitals, or nursing homes, as these facilities have their own evacuation procedures. Make sure to tie a white or bright colored towel to your door or mailbox. This will notify your local civil authorities that you are fully aware of the situation and obey the evacuation order. If you don't evacuate, you will put your life at risk. Do not delay. Evacuate now to protect your life. Repeating, a volcano warning is now in effect for all areas within a 500-mile radius of the Bruno-Jarbid supervolcano. This station will go off the air until further notice. Evacuate now. Repeat, evacuate now. Do not hesitate.
Sometimes saying ayo, got is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. The eruption of the Supervolcano is imminent, and it is expected to occur within the next 2 hours. It is now too late to evacuate. I repeat, it is now too late to evacuate. If you are within a 500-mile radius of the Supervolcano, you will face certain death. All areas will be completely annihilated, and will be covered up with several meters of ash. If you have already evacuated, do not return home, as there is no home to return to. Shelters are being put up in the following states: Florida, New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, North Carolina, and Georgia. Those areas will receive little to no ash fall after the eruption. Continue to monitor local radio stations for more information on this dangerous situation. Repeating, the eruption of the Supervolcano is imminent, and it is expected to occur within the next 2 hours. It is now too late to evacuate. To repeat, it is now too late to evacuate.
Good morning, Reno. At this time, we are going to coverage some breaking news coming out of Idaho. The Buena-Jabrich supervolcano in southwest Idaho is on a verge on eruption and is likely to begin shortly. Once it erupts, everything within a 75-mile radius will be completely obliterated and will be rendered uninhabitable. Everything within a 500-mile radius will be covered with several meters of ash and will block out the sun for the next few years, and will cause temperature drops across the world, resulting in many crop failures in the process. This is truly something very extraordinary, and not in a good way. I honestly can't believe that this is happening, as a supervolcanic eruption has not occurred during the occupation of civilized humans. And apparently, this is going to be the first one ever, and hopefully the only one. What's this? Oh my God! The volcano has just erupted. To those of you listening to KKOH, we are going to cut our broadcast short as we seek immediate shelter. You guys know the drill, seek an underground shelter. Now.
Regular programming at the request of the White House to participate in the emergency alert system.
During this emergency, most stations will remain on the air to provide news and information to the public in assigned areas. This is KDVN. We will continue to serve the Reno area. If you are not in this local area, tune now into stations providing news and information for your local area. You are listening to the emergency alert system serving the Reno area. Do not use the telephone. The telephone line should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. Stand by. A representative of the president will be speaking shortly. Good morning, my fellow Americans. I am speaking on behalf of the president, as he is currently sheltering in a safe and undisclosed location in Washington, D.C. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government. This is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. I regret to inform the citizens of the United States that at 8:45 a.m. Mountain Daylight Time, the Brno-Jobridge Supervolcano located in Idaho has erupted as a result of an 8.7 earthquake that struck the caldera 2 days ago. This eruption has sent a massive ash cloud more than 15 kilometers in the atmosphere. This eruption has been confirmed to be a VEIA eruption, meaning that this is a mega colossal eruption, and is likely this will result in a global volcanic winter. This will result in many crop failures across the globe, as temperatures will immediately drop to near 1 degree Celsius, and the sun will be blocked entirely for many years to come. All residents of the United States, no matter where you are, you must seek an underground shelter immediately. Gather the necessary supplies such as food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a fully charged cell phone, phone chargers, a flashlight, and a battery-powered door hand crank radio with extra batteries, and a first aid kit. Do not leave your shelter of all times. If you go outside for any reason without a mask rated in DC, you will die immediately from lung failure. Shelters have been put up in the previously mentioned states, as they will receive little to no ash fall from the eruption. Continue to monitor local radio stations for the latest information on this catastrophic situation. Thank you, and may God bless the United States of America.
You're listening to Noah's All Hazards Radio, station KWO35 in New York City. This broadcast originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office located on the grounds of Brookhaven National Laboratory in Upton, New York. Station KWO35 broadcasts on a frequency of 162.55 MHz. For the following areas, in New Jersey, Bergen, Essex, Hunterdon, Hudson, Mercer, Middlesex, Morris, Passaic, Somerset, Sussex and Union, and the following areas, in New York, Bronx, Kings, Nassau, Putnam, Queens, Richmond, Rockland, Staten Island, Suffolk and Westchester. Freeze warning in effect from 1 a.m. to 10 a.m. Monday. What? Sub-freezing temperatures as low as 25 expected. Where? In New Jersey, Bergen, Essex, Hunterdon, Hudson, Mercer, Middlesex, Morris, Passaic, Somerset, Sussex and Union counties. In New York, Bronx, Kings, Nassau, Putnam, Queens, Richmond, Rockland, Staten Island, Suffolk and Westchester counties. When, from 1 a.m. to 10 a.m. Monday,
impacts, frost and freeze conditions will kill crops and other sensitive vegetation and possibly damage unprotected outdoor plumbing. Take steps now to protect tender plants from the cold. To prevent freezing and possible bursting of outdoor water pipes, they should be wrapped, drained, or allowed to drip slowly. Those that have in-ground sprinkler systems should drain them and cover above-ground pipes to protect them from freezing. Messages transmitted at the request of the National Weather Service in conjunction with the Federal Emergency Management Agency. After the eruption of the Brunei-Jabrig supervolcano that happened later today, temperatures across the world have dropped by negative 15 degrees Celsius. It is believed that the planet is suffering a volcanic winter. Countless reports of famines have been coming in due to freezing temperatures worldwide. Already, 1 million people have died due to the lack of crops as a result of them failing due to widespread sub-freezing temperatures. Everyone who is receiving this message are advised to do the following instructions. Stay in your homes at all costs. Wear multiple layers of clothing or blankets to keep yourself warm during this time. Drink plenty of hot chocolate to stay warm. Have a battery-powered or hand-crank radio with you to get the latest news and information regarding on this situation. Stay tuned to the station or other radio stations on the latest information. The following message is transmitted at the request of the National Weather Service in conjunction with the Federal Emergency Management Agency. After the eruption of the Brunei-Jabrig supervolcano that happened later today, temperatures across the world have...
Your reflection looking back to pull you down. Are you gonna die today? Make it.